Decoupage is the process of beautifying ordinary and everyday objects. Usually, when you want to make an object look better, you have to either draw or paint over it. But the process of decoupage, in which you use paper or pieces of paper to stick on any object, cuts short the whole process and the time also. Grown-up and children both can learn and practice and enjoy the art of decoupage. The basic items for decoupage are as follows. Firstly, the object on which the decoupage is to be done. In this case, we are using a glass bottle. Next is the decoupage tissue paper. It is a normal tissue paper, but it has got some good, beautiful designs. This tissue paper is to be stuck on the object. Next is the artist gesso. It is basically a white primer. It is applied on the object before sticking the tissue paper. This is done so that the tissue paper colors and any other color, if you want to apply, comes up vibrant on it. Next is Mod Podge. Mod Podge is a special decoupage glue. It has a 3-in-1 function. It acts as a sealer, glue and finisher. And lastly, we have a pair of flat brushes. These brushes are used to apply gesso and Mod Podge on the object. The first step in decoupage is applying of gesso. Use a flat brush and directly apply a gesso on the surface of the bottle. Apply in broad, even strokes. The consistency of the gesso is such that it will automatically spread out evenly. Make sure that you completely cover the area in gesso. See, the gesso has now dried completely. Now we can start with the process of applying the tissue paper on the bottle. This is the tissue paper which we are now going to prepare for application on the bottle. There is a special technique which is used to open the tissue paper and to cut the desired pattern as we require. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take these two figures so that they fit on either side of the bottle. Now we are going to trace an outline over here for the figures, and we are going to cut out these tissue paper, these figures from the tissue paper. We are actually going to tear by hand so that we can have that cutting effect of the tissue, which will look very good on the final decoupage product. And start tracing the outline of the picture where you want to tear off. You need not worry too much on the shape of the outline, and but make sure that the central portion of the picture comes within the torn part. After this, using your fingers, just start tearing off the edges of the picture. Now you can see how the tissue has been torn at the edges, and these are the two pictures which are now ready for pasting on the bottle. Important thing to note about the tissue paper or the decoupage tissue paper is that it can contain more than one ply. So sometimes you have a 2-ply tissue paper or a 3-ply tissue paper. The ply only means that there are those many number of tissue papers layers in one tissue paper. Now if you see here, we have separated all the layers. The first layer onto your left is completely white. There afterwards, there is a fine imprint of the picture on the next tissue paper. And finally, there is the picture which is actually printed. The last layer of the tissue is so thin that sometimes the picture appears same on both sides.
we have to make sure that all the plies are separated and only the last layer of the printed tissue paper is used. The next step in decoupage is application of Mod Podge on the bottle. As you can see, we are applying Mod Podge in broad parallel strokes on the surface of the bottle. Right now we are applying Mod Podge on a very small portion of the bottle and then gently placing the tissue paper on the bottle. In this technique, we are going portion by portion from one side. Gently tap the tissue paper on the bottle so that it sticks onto the Mod Podge. One part of the tissue paper is now stuck to the bottle. So we apply Mod Podge to the next part of the bottle and slowly roll over the tissue paper so that it sticks evenly. The most difficult part or the most tedious part in this whole process is placing of the tissue paper. The tissue paper has to be flush with the bottle. Preferably, there should be no wrinkles on it, and keep applying a layer of Mod Podge over the tissue paper and the sides so as to stick it and seal it also. Apply Mod Podge over the edges. Notice how the paper crimps towards the edges because of the shape of the bottle. But the tissue paper being very, very thin, it easily takes on the shape of the bottle. One has to really go slow on this process so as to prevent any bubbles from being trapped between the bottle gesso and the tissue paper. Once you have satisfied with the placement of paper, you can apply the final layer of Mod Podge as a finisher. As you can see, there is a gap between the top of the bottle and where the tissue paper finishes. So over there we are going to apply acrylic colors with the help of a sponge. We have chosen the color as close as the tissue paper so that it merges and it gives a good finish. Finally, when the whole thing is dried, you can now apply a final layer of Mod Podge as a finisher and a sealer. Depending on which Mod Podge we use, you can either get a matte finish or a gloss finish. For the purpose of this video, we are using gloss. So when it dries completely, we are going to get a gloss finish over it. Mod Podge also helps to seal the colors and the layers of tissue to provide it a certain level of protection against dust and other elements which it can be exposed, and it also seals the final colors. With this, the process of decoupage is complete, and now we'll have to wait for the whole thing to dry off.